الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. We continue with the wasaya of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in hadithi of Mu'adh ibn Jabal رضي الله تعالى عنه. And we were talking about the shirk and how the shirk is the most noxious things and how to protect ourselves from the shirk. And the first wasiya was to not commit shirk. قال وإن حرقت أو قتلت كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, even if you will be, you know, facing to be killed or mutilated or subhanallah burned. And we have explained that one had the ability actually to say the words of the kufr, of blasphemy, as long as the heart is sound. And we explained, you know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying such a hadith, or what has been reported by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to have us to be very mindful of the meaning of the shirk, and we have explained that in more than a session. So here he's saying, "قال كما نرى أنه صلى الله عليه وسلم قد حمى جانب التوحيد أعظم حماية حين نهى عن صلاة التطوع لله سبحانه وتعالى عند طلوع الشمس وعند غروبها لئلا يكون ذريعة إلى التشبه بعباد الشمس إلى آخره." You see the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the way how he was protected, the creed and the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the foundation of the aqidah of Islam, from all the perspective, to the point that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made forbidden and prohibited for anyone to even to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a time that used to be or still used for people to offer prayer on that time, and they are worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like those who, you know, worship the sun and so on. So if you think why it's haram and forbidden to make salat nafilah between the fajr time and the shuruq, the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, قال الشمس تطلع بين قرنين من قال تطلع بين قرني الشيطان, in the meaning of the hadith that the sun, subhanallah, it rises between the horn of the shaitan, which is actually gives us the idea to understand that the shaitan has horns. And what the meaning of the hadith? Because the people who, the pagan who worship the sun, their prayer is at the time of the sunrise. So the shaitan comes, subhanAllah, in the farthest horizon in the sea. And when the sun rises, you see the extension or the extended, you know, shadow. So the extended shadow, when they pagan, they make sujood and prostrate, is actually they're prostrating between the two horn of the shaitan. You see, when you, in the beginning, how is very extended the shadow, right? And when you put anything, especially at the time of the sunrise. So imagine the farther a person goes, like the shaitan, la'anahullah, into the sea. So when it rises, from when you look at it, comes from behind the, from the high, behind the horizon, in the farthest point of the sea. He will be standing there. And then when the sign, subhanAllah, sun rises from between the two horns of the shaitan. And he enjoys it, because when they're prostrating the sun, he's prostrating to him, la'anahullah. None of the believer will be doing his salat at that time thinking of such a thing. But look how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he emphasized on the most subtle things to help the believer be always aware of how damaging, how devastating, how corrupting the action of the shirk. Because as we have explained, the action of the shirk is not just to associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as being portrayed by, you know, many in the way of the definition. And the worst of the partner that we associate with Allah is our own self. And the worst of the partner is the way one thinks that he or she can make their way of life based in or relying on other system than the system of Allah. And that is the worst of the shirk, especially in nowadays. For the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had us to be mindful of such a thing, to not have in any way to be resembling in our worship pagans or people who doing, you know, other types of worship that conflict with our way, alhamdulillah. After, you know, a short conclusion or khulasa of what we have studied so far. إن السجود والعبادة والتوكل والإنابة إن السجود والعبادة والتوكل والإنابة والتقوى والخشية والتحسب والتوبة والنذر والحلف والطواف بالبيت والدعاء كل ذلك محض حق الله تعالى. So here what we say حق is Allah سبحانه وتعالى right, which are the سجود, the worship, tawakkul, reliance, inaba, you know, turning back to Allah. Piety is for Allah. Righteousness for the sake of Allah. If people, you know, to be honest and kind in which way? You're giving, you're sharing, you're helping, you're being generous in the which way? If you do it for the way of yourself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept anything. وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ وَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. And Allah will come in the day of judgment for whatever deeds they have done is going to be scattered like the dust into the wind. Why? Because the action, the good deed will not only be regarded only when it's done in the way of Allah, for the sake of Allah, and this is the right of Allah from the creation that He created who are us. قال والخشية, the fear, and تحسب والتوبة, and to seek in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward, repentance, you know, promising, swearing, pledge, oath, going around the Kaaba, the tawaf, or the bait, because the people, they doing tawaf around the graves, or they doing tawaf around anything else, that's a shirk, that's kufr. The only ibadah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed as being the tawaf is around the Al-Kaaba Sharif. فهذا حق الله تعالى لا يصلح لسواه من ملك مقرب أو نبي مرسل. So none of these action can be offered or done or performed for a king or even the greatest of the messenger, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Actually, to honor the Prophet, the true love of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, is to not associate or to not grant him or believe that he has any attribute of the divine. Some of the other shirk, that is very spread, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in this hadith, قال في حديث عن عقبة بن عامر مرفوعا قال من تعلق أو علق تميمة فلا أتم الله له ومن تعلق ودع أو علق ودع فلا ودع الله له وفي رواية من تعلق تميمة فقد أشرك. The tamima is the thing for people that they put that like for the good omen, they wear something, say it's good luck, or the wada, and wada is like the seashell, you say this is has, you know, healing, it has, you know, bring, you know, good luck, protect you. So all that type of evil omen or good omen, all of it is rejected in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a matter of fact, those people who do that, not only is not helping them, but is destroying the barakah that they could have gotten from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if someone, for example, pray, alhamdulillah, he's Muslim and everything, but when they have a problem, they go to people to help them, write for them something, to either, you know, wear it as a necklace or to keep it in their pocket, that's actually conflicting. These people, they do not know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that what people regarded as very small thing, it really corrupt all the system of the faith. It really invalidate one's prayer. The prayer will not be even accepted. Look, we might think of it as small, but when you think about it deeply, you find it's really big violation in the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Huh? It's like someone telling you, I'm going to help you, I'm going to take care of you, I'm going to do this. I said, great, you know, I'm here, you know, relying on you. Example. And when he's saying that, he's already in connecting someone else to secure for him, for example, a ticket for this place. So the person that he's going to tell you, I'm going to take care of you, you know, and sincerely, he already prepared everything. If he hears about it, what he going to think? Say, this person is not trusting me. Actually, I'm doing this is all from my time and being like paying everything. And this person, he's not like, you know, kind of regarding with esteem, just have, you know, just a little bit of, you know, respect. But imagine this, you transport it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. So when you say someone go to anybody to help them, you know, think that they're going to be protected by some anything that they carry into their pocket or they put it as a necklace or things, said it's like you're saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes, I trust in you, but you know there's other things that help me, secure me more, give me more confidence. What does it mean? You see, you look at it, you know, small, but in reality it's big. In reality it's big. قَالَ فَلَا تَنْسَ ذَلِكَ وَاذْكُرْ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, worship Allah and do not associate any partner with Him. And the saying in Surah Al-An'am, الأنام قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. Say indeed my prayer, my sacrifice, my way of dying, my way of living, my way of dying is all for Allah, the God of the worlds. There is no partner with Him. واحذر أن تكون من المشبهة أي الذين يشبهون الله تعالى بالحوادث. And be careful to not be from those who are resembling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His creation, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing is like Him, nothing compared to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. So those things also for the believer has to reflect on them to know who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From a perspective of a description, but from a perspective also and mainly from the names of Allah and the attributes of Allah. But living in a society where they regard the God that it can be a body and human being that comes and walk in the earth, and a human being that came and visited Ibrahim and he washed his feet, a human being that turned, you know, to be the Savior and then, you know, turned to be a spirit and then God. So this is very present around us. So people want the way that they are reacting toward God, toward the religion, because they have this concept of a God, you know, is kind of binding to body. And the believers